What do you do, my people? This is your boy Joseph coming in. So apparently today, guys, in Vegas, it's on a Sunday crossover 101, and you actually do not expect to see an NTV news anchor. What is he doing in Nakuru? I mean, he's supposed to be somewhere in Nairobi. Anyway, guys, here he is, Trevor Ombija. How are you?
Awesome, my man. How are you doing?
You go to Kwanzaa.
Fantastic.
Welcome to Vegas, friends.
And I love your energy.
We love the energy.
We don't do this very often, but I think you're doing a fantastic.
You love it, right?
Awesome.
So how does it feel working for NTV?
It's brilliant. It's challenging at the same time. Every day is a new experience. Yeah. Like you said, today NTV's on the road. You're in county number 32. You guys call it Nax Vegas.
Vegas, whatever happens in Vegas.
Days in Vegas, you know. Yeah, but it's an awesome experience.
Amazing. Well, I don't know if you are fully aware, but there were rumors that probably you hadn't studied media. Like, you had done law, I guess. Is it true?
Whoa, no.
You had done law.
No. That's not true.
I'm
one of those people practicing exactly what they studied for. Journalism and media studies.
Study?
Broadcast major, University of Nairobi. Comrade power.
Babu, you know.
Yeah.
Amazing. For how long have you been doing this? Anchoring, that is.
6 years.
Anchoring. So,
yes.
The first anchoring job at NTV?
No. My first anchoring job was at Nation FM. It's still part of NMG, but I was
Nation
a news
FM,
anchor on radio. That was very much different from the television gig I have, right?
How was it like transitioning from radio to television?
Interesting. People have different opinions. Sometimes you appear on screen and they're like, ay, ujamange baki to radio. Yes.
So,
for a moment there, you're wondering, is that a compliment or this?
But you can't help it.
Yeah, you can't help it. People decide what they want to see, and there's always judgment all the time, but it's different. Radio is much more relaxed.
Yeah.
Television, you have to be strict. You have to know what you're doing. You have to wear, put on a suit and a tie.
Actually, it's on a Sunday. Why are you wearing a suit and a tie? Why?
Someone once told me that we always unnecessarily overdressed.
Yeah, exactly. No, I guess why do you? What are some of the challenges, if you may say?
First of all, when you're out here, there's a lot of technical issues.
Yeah,
because you have to coordinate with the studio in Nairobi. You might lose some sound. Sometimes you're flying blind. Your directors don't know what's going on, and you're the one who has to anchor it from there. And you also don't want to look like an idiot on air.
Sure.
So you always have to find something to say, man. And then always people will always criticize you. No matter what you do, someone will not like what you do.
Yeah.
So it's upon you to decide and sort of sift through the chaff and the real stuff, and then make sure you stay on course.